Hi there, it's Kevin from RogueDeckBuilder.com here with match number 2 in the Standard Daily Tournament with Junk Midrange. I am on the play here, and this is a great hand. I've got an Avacyn Pilgrim that can lead into a turn 2 Borderland Ranger. So, and we have all of our colors, all of our mana sources. So this is definitely a keep hand. This is not only a keep hand, but it's a great hand. So we'll throw out a forest here so the rest of our lands can come and play untapped and pass the turn to him. And we'll go for the Borderland Ranger, thin out our deck some more, go grab like a plains, and pass it back to him. And it looks like we're facing Jund here, and I'm liking this because Jund is a very good matchup for us. So, and with the fast start, with a Sever the Bloodline and a Thragtusk, this looks like it's going to be our game. So anyway, we'll get in there for 3. And it puts out a key rune, and I don't like the key runes because they can block my Thragtusk, and a very good card. That's by far the best key rune, is the Rakdos one. We'll throw out a Garruk here. And Olivia's great because now we can just sever the Garruk, but he does Dreadbore or sever the Olivia, but he does Dreadbore our Garruk, which we already got some value out of him at least, so the Garruk does get a beast token and a Dreadbore out of the way. So we'll sever the Olivia here and swing in there. And next turn we have a Thragtusk or a Sorin, and he's at 11. But he plays a Thragtusk of his own. And we'll just throw out our own Thragtusk and attack with our beast token. And he does block, which is okay. But a miracle bonfire off the top, takes out all 3 of our creatures. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We'll do 6 damage to us, and allow him to attack with his beast, or we'll have to jump into it. So that was the best card he could have drawn. This is miracles for you. The bonfires get you every time. But he doesn't attack, which is good. So we'll throw out a Sorin here, and put a vamp. And we're still feeling like we're doing pretty good, but looks like he top decks a Rakdos Return. So it takes our card draw away from us and kills our Sorin. So now we're in bad shape, top decking lands, and we can't attack into his beast because he'll just block it. But he does let us attack into it, but now he's got his own beast attack to us and a Rakdos Key Rune and 2 cards ahead of us, so we're actually looking behind in this game. So we need to top deck something soon, and that's not what we wanted to see. Wanted to see a Thragtusk Farm before we see another Restoration Angel. So yeah, I have no clue why he chose to cast the beast token instead of the Thragtusk, because he could have had two more trample go through if he would have targeted the Thragtusk. Anyway, not that it makes a difference in this game. But now we're going to have to think about severing those beast tokens, which we'll do. And now it's 1 to 2 cards, but he's got a Rakdos Key Rune and a Kessig Wolf Run, and he gets another Thragtusk out. So right now we're just being outdrawn, like big time outdrawn. Drawn Overgrown Tomb, which doesn't help. So we have a pretty fast clock now that we're going to have to deal with. So I decide just to run the Restoration Angel into the Thragtusk. And it'll take us down to 1 here if he pumps it. And we're hoping to draw anything here, anything to keep us alive. But we suck out and get a Borderland Ranger. So anyway, that was game number 1. We'll go on to game number 2. This hand's a keep hand too. Same thing. We get a second turn Borderland Ranger. And we have a Celestia Charm to get rid of a Thundermaw Hellkite or a Thragtusk. And that's a great draw too, because we can go get a black source here with our Borderland Ranger, and next turn we can get a Sorin online, which puts him on a pretty fast clock if we generate a token or two and then start minus 2ing in for the emblems. So we'll throw out the Sorin and put out a dude and pass back to him and hope he doesn't have a bonfire, which it looks like he's stuck on 3 lands. No, he does play a land, but we're okay here. He can't activate his key rune. And Gavony was the absolute best draw ever we could have drawn. So now we'll just put out another Borderland Ranger, go thin our deck out some more, and hold up mana for the end of turn to throw in a Celestia Charm. So I decided to put out another token and swing, and see what he does. And he throws out another key rune, so he's digging. He has no answers in his hand. And yeah, it looks like he's dead on board here. If we he can't activate one key rune next turn, but he decides to Far Seek, and I think is he dead even without the, let's see, 2, 3, that's 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. No, he's not quite dead, but with the Celestia Charm, he is dead on board even without seeing the Gavony. I mean, he would have died with the Gavony, but the Celestia Charm just puts a nail in the coffin. So that was a quick game for us. So we'll go on to game number 3. And this hand's kind of slow, but Jun's not incredibly quick either. So I do like the Vraska and the Angel Serenity and the Disciple Bullis. And all of our colors, all of our mana sources. I don't like to see that Deathrite Shaman. They're a pain in the butt. But he has no red, so we're doing okay. Looks like he's stuck on a land too. He probably should have played any land besides the Kessig, so I'm thinking that he's stuck on two lands. So we'll keep up the mana here to see if he attacks into it again with the Celestia Charm, but he wisens up this time and doesn't attack into it, which is unfortunate. But we'll go ahead and O-ring that key rune, because I know that, you know, he played these lands out of sequence here, so I know he's stuck on three lands. So we'll get rid of the key rune. He draws another land, and out comes the Huntmaster. So we need to draw something quick. So I decide to throw out a Vraska here and plus one it. So if they attack into the Vraska, it's a 2-for-1. But he decides to hit me instead. And he puts out a key rune, and I'll kill that next turn with Vraska. I know he's still kind of hurting on lands. And we'll put out a Thragtusk to defend our Vraska. But once again, he gets another land, and the Rakdos return is really unfortunate here. I'm trying to decide what to pitch here, and deciding to pitch two Celestia Charms and an Angel Serenity. In hindsight, I don't know if that's the best move. Maybe I should have pitched the Disciple, but I want the Disciple up to draw a ton of cards off the Rakdosk, or maybe even the Sever, because I can flash the Sever back, and the Angel Serenity could give me tons of value late game, but I decided to pitch the Angel Serenity. And Vraska dies too from the Rakdos' redirection. But I do decide to Disciple here for a bunch of cards. And I like what I see here. We got the Acidic Slime to take out his Rootbound Crag. I've already taken two red sources out by the Oblivion Ring, the Key Rune, and the Vraska and the other Key Rune. But I don't know if that was a... Wait, I couldn't have... Okay. Anyway, let's back up here. And we will Acidic Slime his Rootbound Crag, deactivating his Kessig Wolf Run here, and those shamans are getting quite annoying, and I think I make a horrible misplay next turn. That, once again, I need to watch what I'm doing here, because he's able to exile his own Rootbound Crag for red mana. He throws out Olivia, and I play this in the wrong sequence, which I do think ends up costing me the game, because I sever the bloodline to Olivia and then decide to run out of Garouk and kill off a shaman. And he's able to, in response, exile my Sever the Bloodline, which I could have used later on in this game. So from here on out, I just, you know, it's bad luck here because we just get outdrawn big time. We have so many lands as it is on board, and we just keep drawing into nothing. I mean, that's a decent card to draw here, and I decide to throw a Thragtusk and pass the turn in case he has some shenanigans that I can Celestia Charm. But he Far Seeks into another red source. I mean, he's just drawn card after card after card that he needs. I mean, he needs the red source, he draws it, And we'll O-ring the stupid Deathrite Shaman here so we can have a free sever. And we'll go ahead and sever the Huntmaster so it can't flip on us again and keep gaining him life. But we're in pretty good shape here. I'm still liking our chances here. I mean, the Dreadboar goes out, and we got two beast tokens with that are able to Gavony every turn. And a Sorin that he just wasted Dreadboar on a Thragtusk, so I'm liking our odds here. So anyway, he's able to sever the two beast tokens and attack into Sorin, and I have to block to keep my Sorin alive. And now I'm just drawn dead. Drawn land after land after land. We do have a sever. Maybe I should have severed the wolves there, but I wanted to save sever for a better target. But bonfire right here is going to make it so my Sorin dies, but I will decide to keep the vampire alive and force an attack into my Sorin. So anyway, once again, another land. And I could have severed there, which I probably should have. But a Dreadboar is my token. And we're able to Slesnia Charm, grab a knight, and pump it. But he's got Abrupt Decay for it. So, I mean, he is just drawing everything he needs, and I'm drawing the lands. I hate these games where you get just outdrawn. And I'm able to Acidic Slime again his red source, putting him back a land. But he's able to sever that Acidic Slime. So he can't flash back any of his severs, so we're still in good shape, but not when we're drawing cards like this. But Avacyn Pilgrim is even a decent draw because we can pump it up higher than his wolves, which we'll do here. And he can't Kessig here. He has no red source. And we're able to kill off a wolf token. But a Thragtusk comes on board, which it's putting us on a pretty fast clock if we can't find an answer, but that's the fourth land in the row that I've drawn. Or, well, no, I guess I drew the Avacyn Pilgrim, but we're just drawing way too many lands here. But I will keep my Pilgrim alive by blocking the wolf, and I'll give him lifelink as well to mitigate some of the damage from the Thragtusk. But a Gurk was out, and he's able to draw five cards off his Thragtusk. Now we're, you know, card disadvantage big time. And the Sever is actually, it's a decent card, but it's not one we want to see right now. And he, you know, gets a Sever off of that, able to swing in with this Thragtusk, and I know I'm dead from like a pillar or anything next turn. Which, we do draw a land again. And we can Sever the Thragtusk and Sever the Thragtusk token, but I mean the odds are that he has a bonfire in hand, or a pillar, or another Rakdos return is just so high that I know I'm dead here. So we do. We die to a pillar, but which is otherwise a dead card. There's nothing really in our deck that a pillar can hit that it can kill besides a Borderland Ranger or a Arbor Elf, but or a Avacyn Pilgrim. So a little unfortunate for us. We end up, you know, just getting outdrawn. This usually is a very favorable matchup, which is funny because I win all my matchups that are unfavorable this tournament and lose the matchup that I am favorable against. So that was game number two, or match number two. Game number three of the Standard Daily. This has been Kevin with RogueDepper.com. Thanks for watching.